You might find new use for your old speakers after watching this video. Little while ago I built these two-way tower speakers out of plywood. They each feature Aiyma 3-inch full-range driver, crossover parts out of old DIY speakers and two about 5-inch midbass drivers from old Sony speakers. You cannot see those midbass drivers because they are inside of 6th order bandpass enclosure and sound comes out only from this port at the front. How this bandpass enclosure works and more about this design later. But first, why and how to use old speakers in your project. Two reasons why you might use old speaker elements are: you want to redesign a speaker cabinet or to save few bucks using elements you already got. First, you need some data, some specs about these old speakers. TLS small parameters are a set of speaker parameters that we can use to design a custom enclosure. You might find these online by a model name that is printed on the magnet. In mass-produced speakers like the Sony's, there is no information on the web, so we need to measure them. And that can be done using Dayton Audio Touch device and its program on the PC. These parameters then can be used on a speaker enclosure simulation software, like a horn resp. If, however, these two options are not available for you, it is better to keep the new design simple. You can measure inside dimensions of the old cabinet and calculate the air volume. Keep that same air volume in your new design. But you can change the shape of the box. If it's a reflex design, first, measure the port area. Radius of the port is half the diameter. Area of the port is pi times radius squared. Measure the port length and keep the area and port length the same for your new design. If you want to change the port size but to keep the tuning same, first keep the cabinet air volume the same. Measure your port area and the length. If you double the port area, you need to double the port length also. Your port can be between these dimensions also. This gives you roughly the same tuning, but not exactly. Same goes if you have the port area, then half the port length. If you use multiple ports, add together port areas and keep the length within the same scale. All the ports should be the same size and length. These examples on the screen would give you about the same tuning, even though the port size changes. Let's get to building these tower speakers. First, we disassemble these midbass drivers out of these Sony cabinets. I think these may be 20 or 15 years old. This old Sony design has really poor crossover and maybe too many tweeters. But we are interested only about these midbass drivers. They have a plastic cone but reasonable magnet and cone throw. Rubber surround has these wrinkles, probably to help with the high excursion. I actually got two pairs of these speakers. Different model but almost exactly the same drivers. So next we measure all of them in the touch and compare results to see if any of these speakers is too much out of tolerance with other drivers. We use average parameters of the drivers in the enclosure design software. It's good to start with the simulating old factory design enclosure to see does that correspond into our experience. Here it does. Factory design sounds okay, but has no lower bass output. In this factory design, these drivers are responsible in bass and also in the mid-range. With our new design, we can use full-range drivers in the mid-range. After trying out few designs, using series-tuned 6th order bandpass enclosure seems fun idea. Tower designs gives more room what bandpass enclosure needs. Speaker enclosures is always a compromise. This design has pretty wide frequency range, about 35 up to 175 Hz. But it is larger and not that sensitive. Bass still blows away factory design. Obviously, having two drivers helps, but this enclosure gives also much deeper bass, and for my surprise, it's punchy and clear in the mid-bass range. In a six-ordered bandpass design, drivers are middle of two reflex enclosures. This is series tuned. That means that the other reflex enclosure feeds into the front one. Having only a port to output sound, thus natural high frequency filtering. Bandpass designs passes through only a band of frequencies. So that means it will somewhat dampen harmonics and driver noises. I wanted to make this cabin as narrow as possible, so that meant cutting the driver baskets. Getting a cabin size right and fitting the ports was a little bit of a hassle, and air volumes didn't end up exactly as planned. They came a little larger, but close enough that it works quite well. For the mids and highs, I ordered from eBay a pair of Aiyma or Aiyma 3-inch full-range drivers. One of them came with two spiders. After vacuuming that, I measured the ear height in the listening position, and these speakers are at that height in the final design. Also measured these drivers with the DATs, because there was no specs online. These parameters helped to design a crossover. Crossover is on the bottom of the speakers, and is using recycled DIY speaker parts. There is 12 dB high pass filter for the Aiyma and 6 dB low pass for the Sony mid-bass drivers. Cabin was made of 15mm spruce plywood and was painted with the white tinted lacquer. Feet are 4 bolts that can be adjusted a little bit up and down. This was really fun, a really interesting build. I never done 6th order bandpass enclosure before. I'm happy how it looks. There is some marks on the wood, spruce is pretty soft wood, but the lacquer helps to hide them. Enclosure didn't turn out exactly as planned. Mid bass is louder for some reason than the lower bass, so I had to EQ that down. But overall, I'm happy how it sounds, remembering how cheap this was. I needed to buy only the full range driver, wood, pots and screws, and the lacquer. There's some tweaking that can be done. Maybe I revisit this one day. Hopefully, this was also helpful for you. And I leave you with the sound demo. My recording setup is not very good and it will be in mono. But maybe it's better than nothing. See you soon.